Hey guys, you're Broke Your Prayers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where last time I left off. I picked up a win in the league over Arsenal. As defeating Sheffield Wednesday. Sheffield United, sorry. Getting my Sheffield teams mixed up. Sorry about that. It was Sheffield United I defeated in the Capital One Cup. In this episode, I have a league game against Manchester United before I play in my second group stage game in the Champions League, so let's jump in. Now, I didn't mention this in the last episode because I completely forgot. I decided, someone suggested it to me, and I decided to try it out, is you will notice that Origi and Firmino have switched their sides with the striker and Cam sides with Coutinho and Mane. Coutinho and Mane used to be on the left side, and Firmino and Origi used to be on the right. They've now switched. Origi and Firmino are on the left, and Mane and are on the right. I've not done this for any particular reason. That's what someone suggested, something new, something different, freshen it up a bit. Let's go for it. See how it feels. So I've only played the game against Arsenal so far, so can't really have judged it properly. I think I'll give it maybe till January to see how I feel about it this way. I mean, it's the same team, only the players they're playing on are coming down the different side. With Coutinho and Mane on the right, and Origi and Firmino on the left.
Renato Sanchez plays
instead of the other way around.
Sadio Mane joins up top with Divock Origi.
Everything else is the same. Chan, who did recently, accept a new contract. Right, so he's back in good grade. In the good books at Anfield. This match is at Old Trafford, but I play Andrew, so that's why I said Anfield. So yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do with Götze now, because I don't think, unless I get a crazy stupid offer for Emre, he's not gonna be leaving now in January.
It's an advantage for Manchester United. Play on, says the ref.
I've been throwing around some ideas in my head. I've been considering some ideas, looking at some other ideas. I'm going to come up with something. The January transfer window. Normally, I'm relatively quiet in the January transfer window. I'll only make a move if I absolutely have to. But I think this January window coming up will probably be one of the most busiest I've ever been. Depending on what happens, it might be an absolute must-see window. Now, ideally, I'd want to do this in the summer, but I only thought of these ideas once for the past couple episodes. After the closure of the summer window, so anything I don't get done in January, I might revisit in the summer if I feel it's still necessary. But we'll see. I'm going to initiate the ideas I have in my mind. They will be initiated as soon as the window is open on the 1st of January later this season. But we're only We're still in September, so that's still a good bit away. We're going to have a good few matches between now and then.
It'll be a test. It will be, but this is a team that tends to keep the ball, and it tends to take the sting out of the situation.
And so...
shots on here. He's got to it.
We'll see. Maybe I'll change my mind. Maybe I'll come up with different ideas. Just know I have things cooking. Yeah. I don't know if you'll see the fish dish, as it were, or will happen. I don't know. We'll see.
It's a real opening here.
We also might see a goal. Come on. Ah, Ryan, you son of a bitch.
That'll be a throw. Nathaniel Klein. Good reading of the play, anticipating the pass. Here comes the cross. Comes out with a punch to clear the danger. And here's the shot. Two minutes left. That's added time.
Firmino.
Look at the looks he's getting off his teammates. They thought he was going to...
I can understand your frustrations, Roberto. For God's sake, that was a really bad miss. Went better or in the second half.
Here's Shaw.
Hopefully I'll at least... produce shots that will test Ryan and hopefully beat him. And he keeps the ball in! Oh, Renato Sanchez's attempt is blocked by Luke Shaw. It was almost blocked by Ikogba as well. My own players are knocking each other over. Nathaniel Klein! Has only... he scored one goal so far taking part in this tournament so far, so not the most likely goal scorer. However, Philippe Coutinho is a much more likely goal scorer. That's a new one. Jumping up on the thing, turn around and point to his name. Which many I fans must fucking love. They're fucking drinking it in, man. Yeah, it went off the post, but they all fucking count. If Darmian was a little faster, he probably would have knocked it in for no goal, so... might be 1-0 either way. For the captain of Liverpool. Against Manchester United at Old Trafford. Brings back some memories of CBGs. Always doing, occasionally doing that.
This attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now.
Firmino! Oh, it's the Brazilian doubleheader, Roberto Firmino. Oh no, getting in on the action.
Well, it's a super period of the game for this team. One goal was excellent, but now they've doubled their money.
I wish you could, like, have your avatar do some cool celebrations like the players can do. Except, rather than him just jumping around. How cool would it be if he had, like, if you celebrated with your staff? I mean, where are the Jurgen Klopp-inspired celebrations? Or Jose Mourinho? Well, he does that shit as well.
And it's been...
One time, Jose Mourinho fucking ran the length of the pitch because he was so happy. Gave him a goal. Well, that was actually against Liverpool. That was... That was when they scored the second... Oh, he ran the fucking length of the... It's because he had bested Brendan Rock.
And he could get away here.
Because they made Liverpool to look like fools.
Mata. The break is definitely on. Well, Ali's come and pitched the ball off the toes of the attacker.
Well, as we know, you have to time these.
And that's not the only time he's done it, but that's the
Manchester United
one that is ingrained in my head forever.
Well read by the defender.
Or as a Liverpool fan. Mourinho is not shy to share his opinion. It's when his team are doing well. In fact, he's the first to do that. So, well, that's something the EA should have. Having the managers do some celebrations.
That's very good defending. And the player had nowhere to go. We've got 10 minutes left on the clock.
I mean, I don't see it as a big ass.
Goalkeeper goes down and comes
up. For God's sake.
Brave goalkeeping. He didn't shirk the challenge, did he?
Firmino.
On the attack here.
Three.
Offside called, and we can see again now.
Wow, call that offside layer, could you please? I don't think you quite called it late enough. You fucking imbecile. Hello, that's a foul. That's a foul.
Here's Martial. Emre Can. We could be in. In the clear here.
Mane. Origi. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Renato Sanchez.
Roberto Firmino.
2-0 it is.
Liverpool have won.
2-0 is fine by me. Hey, Philip Coutinho and Roberto for me. Oh.
To play like this in a derby game.
Oh, getting the goals. No. The goals from the striker. There's Mane's little bit of a dry streak goes on. He hasn't scored in a few games. But I'm not going to get too worried. I mean, when he does score again. And you can bet that he will come back with a fury.
West Bromwich Albion 2, Swansea City 2, Middlesbrough 1, Tottenham Hotspur 2, Hull City 1.
I mentioned in the last episode how it was weird how he didn't have the right avatar, have the avatar for Alexander Arnold looking correctly. But if you look at him there. That's correct! But in the game, it's completely fucking different. How can you have him correct there, or in his profile picture, but his avatar, you don't know what the fuck he looks like, apparently? That breaks logic.
Derby County with 1 point. And then reading up the table, second.
You hurt my brain with your stupidity. So you're saying you know what he looks like, but you don't know what he looks like. Which is it? I mean, it makes no fucking sense. It really doesn't. Oh no! Please don't be back. Please don't be back. Please don't be back. Roberto Firmino is out for 2 months! I don't fucking believe it. 2 months out the 1st of October. Fuck. Emery, will you please make up your fucking mind? Please. He's changed it again! And what are you talking about? Oh, you fucking imbecile! You're in the team again! What are you smoking? Can you please make a competent decision if you're capable of doing that? Because it seems like you're not. You fucking imbecile.
I'm not happy being not selected, so I'd like to move in the transfer window.
Really? Because I see you in my starting 11. You've been in the starting 11 for a while now. You signed a new contract, but now you're unhappy again? Will you please make up your mind? You know what? I'm gonna make up his mind for him. Transfer negotiations. I'm doing this live so everyone can see. Get the word out there. He's gonna play until Roberto comes back. But Emre Can, you are gone. Fuck you. You dumb piece of shit. You can't make up your mind where you're coming or going. You can't figure out what you're doing. You clearly are mentally retarded. Because you can't comprehend that you are in the team when you're complaining that you're not getting picked. I don't know how you will come up with that logic. We will be clearly better off without you. Goodbye. Nothing but drama. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? I don't need to put up with this bullshit. I really don't. I can get... There are a million players who I can get instead of you. Who if I want? A million players! I could play anyone instead of you. Who? You're not special, Emery. You're not. And you just signed a new contract, so don't think you're gonna weigh out the contract and get away with it on free. I'm gonna make some big fucking money out of you. You fucking class A-E. You goon.
Liverpool, they're on a bit of a roll. From their last game, an away win against Manchester United.
Yeah, and I think the confidence that they gained from that 2-0 win
will be enough for them here today.
So this is how the hosts line up today. The kind of players that we expect, the kind of performances we expect from the individuals trying to make this formation work.
Yeah, I mean, it can at first glance look cautious, but it just depends.
And I'm, I accidentally didn't take out our right arm.
This is the Liverpool side. Two banks of four. 4-4-2.
Yeah, how it always used to be. Don't see it quite so often these days, but that's a classic formation and really capable of causing problems here today.
It's okay. He can play in our game, that's not whatever. It's not like this is happening in a row. I don't know if it's been that game. It's been some time since the cup game against Sheffield United.
Concede the corner. And it's a header. That's a high-class header and a world-class save.
Well, you could argue it was a good height for him, but what reflexes, what agility he showed there.
Trying to stretch the opposition using the...
Alexander Arnold.
And that'll be a goal kick. Just a little nudge to nudge you in the direction of what's coming up on EA Sports for you. Our coverage of the Premier League fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Spurs.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Oops. Oh, yes, the referee didn't judge the foul. Well, that's one of the ones they normally give a free kick and a yellow card for.
This could be a chance.
I was saying that that was actually a yellow card, if I'm being honest. That was more a yellow card offense than some of the ones I've been given a yellow card for.
Now,
maybe he played on the advantage because they had the ball, but...
Shot on! And there it is, the goal! And it's put...
Look at the good that did them. As... You get. This was his first goal for the club.
And here's the goal again.
Perfect as you like.
And that has opened the
24 minutes. Took to open the scoring in this in this game. I don't think he booked me. Maybe he did go back and book my player after the foul. No, he didn't. Okay, so. He clearly just didn't think it was a foul. Or if he didn't think it was a yellow card offense. So he left play go on, and he didn't think it was a yellow card offense. Can I get this referee more? Oh, shit, he hit, scores again!
Two ahead. They played well to this point, but sometimes a two-goal lead can be a dangerous one. We'll see. Well, let's take another look at the goal. Restarting at 2-0.
What? Idiot. Holy crap, this guy's name is gonna get gonna be hard to repeat over and over again if he's gonna be a constant goal scorer.
Makes a challenge here. Here's Emre Mor. Giving the ball away now. could be dangerous. Not a good challenge by the defender. Well, there's still time if they can get this goal. That'll be a corner.
Tried to prevent the corner, but couldn't. Come on, win that. Wrong way, what are you doing? Oh, okay. Instead of letting it go off the corner, he fucking put it off the goal kick. Dude, man. That was a big help, actually.
Look at that, that speaks for itself. The lack of shots and perhaps reflecting a lack of confidence in this player who he's on the losing side.
Well, there's going to be 3 minutes added on. There's some potential in this move.
Three more. David! 3-0.
I think a manager loves that kind of goal because it was a real team effort the way they moved the ball about. And once it came to the finish, it was an unerring effort.
For Liverpool, it is looking pretty
nice, cool, calm finish. Finish from my main man. My man up front.
Well, this is delightful football from Liverpool today. And the referee has signaled for half time. 3-0 is the scoreline at this point. Well, what a player. What a performance in that first half, Alan.
And there's the half-time whistle.
This could be it.
So far, so good. Good for... this second game in the group stage. How is the other match going? As you'd expect, like a major art defeating or leading Lazio. Oh, but it's only by the goal, 1 goal. So nothing. Is secure yet. For Atletico Madrid.
Because
they look to keep pace with me here before our match.
He's kept it out. In with a header and a
they will only keep pace with me on goal on points as goal difference. I have them completely blown out of the water as David adds his own second to the cup. To the scoreline. In this, one of the opposition players seems to want to join in the celebration. I think he's a bit confused. So we have two players now on half tricks. David and Yigit.
There's good progress with this attack. He might be through. Shot's up! Oh, he had a real go.
Oh, first shot. A drift pass. Oh.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. Tackle here. And that's dealt with the problem. And it's going to be...
I don't know why I kind of sliced it away, but... Oh, well. One way of doing it, I suppose.
Emre Moore. This is how they love to play on the break. Shots on here. Terrific stop. So they're setting up for the corner. Liverpool will get the throw. Attacking well here.
And Ray Moore. Octavius Wayne, first hat trick! He didn't win the header. Brilliant. I thought that was going to be the moment for him.
That is a free kick. And right away, they're playing again. On the attack here. Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. Promise, actually.
It's safely out for a goal kick.
20 minutes of the 90 still to play. He's coming forward with some danger. He's threaded the path through neatly. Shot on!
Why Elmar? As the Austrian side tried to pull a goal back. They're failing miserably, but they're trying. You can't fault them for trying.
Looking good, this move.
David. Can you complete this after? No, I'm Ray Moore. Or will I have to scroll on down? Well, he makes it. Hit. 5, no, and 12. It's just getting a bit hit locked upside now.
The goal, wherever you look at it, it was.
All roads leads to a devastating demise. As Andy Moore scores his second in the competition.
Sometimes being a favourite in a match.
A few players who've bagged a few goals already in the competition.
Because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've shown the class too.
There's good progress with this attack. Saw it coming, cut it out, good work. 5-0 still, and the referee checking his watch. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Spurs, and they have played well, they've stroked the ball around, and they'll be hoping to continue that.
85 minutes played, 5 to go. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it.
Are they going to get a consolation goal? Oh, no. Henry clears it.
And we're hearing there will be 3 added minutes.
They'll have one more chance if they can get past my midfield golden defense. One more chance off the post! Alexander Arnold clears, and that is the end of the match.
Well, it turned out to be a different kind of game to the one perhaps we set up for you at the beginning. Very one-sided.
Yeah, you end up feeling a bit disappointed as a neutral because we didn't really get a contest, but the winning.
Yeah. Players seem very happy. We were needing it. 2 wins from 2.
Moving forward. Oh, he's through.
No hat trick, unfortunately. Yuki and David have to sell for a pair of braces, and there was no more goals in the game between Atletico Madrid and Lazio, so Atletico Madrid did only need the one goal to secure victory. Interesting.
PSV nil.
What else is interesting is the games lined up for the next episode. First of which is Spurs, as you can see. Not sure why I need 2 wins. Couldn't just tell me I'm 1-0. Well, What was it, Reina Sirius Sen 2? The... A bit of a London double head for it. There's and West Ham in the next episode. But that will have to wait until the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.